It's Thursday, July 23rd, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, Tell Everyone, and our scripture is Psalm 105. Give thanks to the Lord and proclaim His greatness. Let the whole world know what He's done. Sing to Him, yes, sing His praises. Tell everyone about His wonderful deeds. Exult in His holy name. Rejoice, you who worship the Lord. Search for the Lord and for His strength. Continually seek Him. Remember the wonders He's performed, His miracles, and the rulings He has given you, children of His servant Abraham, you descendants of Jacob, His chosen ones. He is the Lord our God. His justice is seen throughout the land. He always stands by His covenant, the commitment He made to a thousand generations. This is the covenant He made with Abraham and the oath He swore to Isaac. He confirmed it to Jacob as a decree and to the people of Israel as a never-ending covenant. I will give you the land of Canaan as your special possession. There's enough bad news to go around these days, especially if you snap on the news channels and cry while they endlessly pour on the world's messiness. So let's focus on a little good news, that is, the gospel. Here's the question. How do you share a positive witness for Christ while there's so much going on that's got people wringing their hands and checking their pulses? And will people really hear what you're saying about Jesus when they're so worried? Well, that's really two questions, isn't it? So let's deal with them one at a time, which, by the way, is really the answer to most of life's problems. About sharing a positive witness, even in tough times of crisis, make sure you have a witness before you set about sharing it. That's another twofold checkpoint. First of all, you don't have a witness if you've never given your life to Christ. And by the way, give me a call and we'll make sure of that. Number two, this other part becomes easier because it's just a matter of applying what the psalmist wrote in today's text. Go back over this psalm and ask the questions of what he's telling you to do. Let's unpack what the psalm writer is asking us to consider. The psalmist writes, give thanks to the Lord and proclaim His greatness. So, do that and mark it in your mind how it feels to say those words. Adopt that as your theme for the day or the week, or better yet, your life. The psalmist writes, sing to Him, yes, sing His praises. How about investing $12 in a hymnal for your home, but don't let it collect dust on a shelf. Use it in your devotional time every day. If you can't carry a tune in a bucket, like me, just say the words out loud. In those hymns are so much doctrine and understanding of God's ways and how to proclaim His greatness. Singing them often will embed godliness in your conversation with others. And then the psalmist writes, exult in His holy name. In a post a couple of years ago, I wrote about exulting. That's exactly the kind of relationships pigs have with their mud. They wallow, as pigs do, in mud to rid themselves of parasites. But they also just seem to love it. That's the key to exulting in God. You pursue relationship with God, exulting or wallowing in all He shows you in His Word, because you know He will deal with the parasites of your sin. The wonder it creates in you is guaranteed to shine around for others to see. So, yes, you can share a positive witness, even especially in hard times like now. If you let the Word of God dwell richly in you, it will change you every day, giving your conversation a different tone, bringing the Word of hope to your world. Now for the other question, with all they're worrying about, will they hear? Are you kidding? With all people are concerned and wringing their hands about these days, a good word is the one thing they crave to hear. But in the bigger picture, just remember that it's not in your job description to make them hear. Your job is to make certain what you say is the good news, and the way you say it is born of love in your heart. Let's pray together. Father, hear our prayer today. We are so fearful sometimes of sharing our faith. There's so much misunderstanding and anger these days. Help us to overcome fear and be faithful witnesses. For you today, go graciously to people, care about them, share what God's shown you and done for you, and then leave the worrying to God. He knows how to handle that. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road today. Have a blessed day.